on Seventh Day Adventist Church, but also welcome to the piano concert by Neil Huffaker. And we want to thank you so much for taking time out on your schedule to come and join us here to have a wonderful time and listening to some beautiful selections of hymns and gospel songs by Neil, and we're looking forward to that. But before we begin our concert, I just want to ask if we can please bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father, we thank you so much for gathering us here tonight, Lord. We're so excited to be here, to enjoy a wonderful concert, to listen to some beautiful hymns and beautiful gospel songs, praising you, Lord. We just pray that you will bless our concert, that you will be with our pianist, Neil Huffaker, Lord, and all those who are supporting him and helping him out. Thank you so much, Father, for your love and your care and your grace. Bless us now, Lord, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Well, good evening, everyone. I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. It's a pleasure to play piano for you and share music. My name is Neil Huffaker, and I'm from Joplin. I have a wonderful selection of contemporary songs, classic hymns, gospel songs that I hope you really enjoy, and I hope you'll be blessed by as well as I've been blessed preparing for this and just am blessed by playing the piano in general and sharing music. So I want to thank you for coming out tonight again and to please enjoy. And could we, for the AV, can we turn down the mic on the piano? It's getting some bad feedback for me. Thank you. And this next song I would like to play is a tune called Give Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That one was "Great is the Lord." Psalms, I forget what chapter, but it says, "Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all ye, all the earth. Rejoice and sing. Make a loud noise. Rejoice and sing." You got to be careful, though, sometimes when you make a loud noise. A while back, I was playing in my house in the living room, and it's a neighborhood there, and I was playing some piano, not late at night, but at nighttime in the dark. The sun had set, and I was playing a fairly loud song, and I like to play loud, of course, and it sounds loud in that room. And I was just playing along in my own world, can't really hear anything, and then all of a sudden, I'm halfway through, and I hear a knock on the door, and I'm like, no one has ever knocked on my door after 8 p.m. that I didn't know about. So I walk over, and I open the door, and it's a guy that I don't know. He has his dog, and he was like, I was like, hello? And he's like, was that you playing the piano? And I was like, yeah. He's like, can I come sit on your couch and you play it again? And I'm like, looking around like, do I need to call the police? And so I let him in. He's like, I'm from the neighborhood. I'm down the street. I'll put my dog right here. I'm like, okay. So I've come in. He sits on the couch, and the piano's facing the opposite way, unfortunately. So I'm like trying to look through the little reflection, make sure he's not doing anything. So then I play it for him, and I play another song. Anyway, and he was very appreciative, and we went on our way, and I haven't seen him since, but maybe another time he'll be walking by, and he'll come in and play. So make a loud noise, and you may someone hear you. I'm now going to play a medley of a few quieter songs, some contemporary songs, some hymns, some you might know, and I hope you enjoy. Let's sing that chorus together. Turn your eyes. Amen. Wonderful. That sounded awesome. Thank you. Well, if you ever wanted to, thought you were going to hear the melodeon, tonight is the night you heard the melodeon. This is called the melodeon, and it works upon air, and you just blow into it, and it makes a sound. So if you never heard one, this is what it is. And they're not too expensive, so if you want to learn something, pick it up, you just blow into it, press down. Even my nephew can play it, so you just press on it and blow air. The Bible talks about the God who made the sun, the moon, the stars, the fields, the animals. And the psalm says, "What is man that you are mindful of me?" Someone who is so great and powerful. And in the gospel, it also talks about how God is caring for even the sparrow, just the birds that you see that you don't even think about. So this next song talks some about that. And it says, "If his eye is on the sparrow, then I know that he watches me."
Thank you.
Well, I can't believe I played all my songs already. I have one more song for you tonight. I'd like to thank you all for coming once again. I know I've already talked to some of you, but I'd love to say hi and meet you afterward and leave you with a CD as well. You can see those in the back afterward. But I want to thank you again, and I hope you were blessed and had an enjoyable evening, closing the day out with some inspirational music on the piano. God has done a lot of things for each one of us, whether we realize it or not, or accept it or reject it. He came and died for each one of us. In Philippians, it says that he humbled himself as a servant, came down from heaven, and humbled himself even to death on the cross. The song I'm going to leave you with talks about how can we ever express thanks for that. It says, how can I give thanks for the things that God has done? So tonight, I want to wish you a good evening, and we'll see you afterward. And I want to leave you with my tribute.
Let everyone say, amen, amen. Man, that's such a blessing. Thank you so much, Neil, for sharing your talent, your gift of playing the piano. I'm telling you, as I was sitting there listening to all these familiar hymns, I wanted to sing, amen. I was like, man, let me sing out, you know. Such a blessing. Thank you so much. And I want to thank you all so much for coming out tonight. You know, as we were going through the list, as Neil was playing for us, and, you know, we're so blessed, you know, to be here and to be immersed in his gift that God has given to him, that, you know, a lot of the songs are reminding me of the greatness of God, how great God is. And there are two reasons why God is great. One, he's our creator. God created us. No one else can lay claim to that but God. Some may claim, but their claim is false. Only God is the creator. Two, God is also our redeemer. God redeemed us through the sacrifice of his son, Jesus Christ. And so the greatness of God is exemplified by his creation of us and the redemption of us through Christ. And we are so praised, and we are so blessed to praise the Lord for that greatness. Amen? Amen. Thank you so much for being here tonight. We're going to have a word of prayer, and then we'll be dismissed. Neil said he would love to fellowship with some of you, with anyone who wants to just talk with him. And also, I heard that we have CDs out there that are available, so look into that. But thank you once again for coming out tonight. We're so blessed that you're here. Thank you, Neil, once again, for sharing your gift with us. Before we go, let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father, we are so blessed that you are our great God, that you created us, and that you also have redeemed us. Thank you so much for all that you have done for us, as was reminded to us through the music that was played by Brother Neil. We pray that you will bless us all, Lord, bless your people here as we just hang around, fellowship, talk, and have a great time talking about your goodness. And also, Lord, as we go home, keep us safe on the roads. Take us home safely, Lord, and give us a good night's rest so we can be refreshed for the next day. Thank you, Father, once again, for everything you've done for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hi friends, Pastor Doug Batchelor. It's time to make your plans and mark your calendars to attend our third annual Amazing Facts Youth Conference. The dates are